president said he's going to override the governors. Under what authority would he do that? And to your point, he said several weeks ago, this is all up to the governors.
Well, I think you're posing a hypothetical, and I think we can all hope that
well,
we see governors.
He would override the governors.
You're posing a hypothetical, though. We're assuming that governors are going to keep churches shut down and keep mosques shut down and keep synagogues shut down. That is a hypothetical question, and we will leave it to these faith communities to reopen.
Said if governors don't
we'll leave
to
it to faith communities to reopen.
Their
and Kristen, I think we can all hope that this Sunday people are allowed to pray to their gods across this country.
But
that's a good thing. And I'd also note there's detailed guidance in here about the way that you can clean your facilities, promote social distancing. So this is something that we should all look at and be thankful that we are encouraging these faith communities to reopen and do so in a safe way. And we'll leave it to parishes to open in a safe fashion.
What story is the president referencing?
Does the White House now support these churches that are defying governor's orders and opening up?
The president's been very clear. He wants churches to reopen. He wants them to do it safely. He wants them to do it in accordance with our guidance. It's laid out very detailed. It's posted now, so you can all take a look through it. And he wants to see all of those churches open in a safe fashion.
If the governor does not allow that, does the White House support churches defying these executive orders?
The president's been very clear. He wants to see churches reopen in accordance with his guidelines.
So the answer is yes?
I gave you an answer.
The president would like churches to reopen and do it in accordance with the guidelines.
What specific provision of federal law allows the president to override a governor's
The president
decision.
Will strongly encourage every governor to allow their churches to reopen. And boy, it's interesting to be in a room that desperately wants to seem to see these churches and houses of worship stay closed.
The president said that he has that.
Kayleigh, I object to that. I mean, I go to church. I'm dying to go back to church. The question that we're asking you and would like to have asked the president and Dr. Birx is it safe? And if it's not safe, is the president trying to encourage that? Or does the president agree with Dr. Birx that people should wait?
Jeff, it is safe to reopen your churches if you do so in accordance with the guidelines, which are laid out very stringent detail here about promoting hygiene practices, and there are 5 bullet points and cloth face coverings. If social distancing is not possible, it's recommended intensifying cleanings, promoting social distance. We lay them out meticulously. So I am thankful that we have a president that celebrates the First Amendment. The same amendment that gives you all the ability to ask me questions is there to have the freedom of worship so imams and pastors can go to their churches, can go to their places of worship, and can celebrate what is a First Amendment right in this country, which is to pray to your God and to practice your faith.
And we celebrate that, too. I just want to follow up by saying we celebrate that, too.
And so we should be thankful that there are guidelines to allow us to reengage in that behavior.
We're not asking you if the president or people are allowing Americans to pray. That's not the question.
To gather in their places of worship. To attend church services, to pray together. And the president has laid out a clear path. The CDC has laid out a clear path for this to take place, for our First Amendment to be exercised in a way that is safe and robust.
Let's talk, Gloria, about why the president is doing this and why he's seeing political opportunity here in this pandemic.
Well, it's a muddled mess, first of all. He is seeing political opportunity here. He believes, remember when he told us in April that he was going to open up the churches for Easter Sunday, that it would be a miracle. And I think Kayleigh McEnany herself, when asked a question about opening up the churches by a journalist asking, you know, how can you be sure it's safe? She said, isn't it amazing how many people in this room seem to want to keep those churches closed or something to that effect? And the journalist said, I go to church every Sunday. I object to that. So if you're trying to make this into a faith-based plan here versus those who have no faith, that's absurd. And, you know, the second thing, Kayleigh McEnany was trying to make this into a First Amendment issue, saying that, of course, people have the right to worship, and then said that the president is a great supporter of the First Amendment. Now, we know the president has called the media the enemy of the people time and time again. And I think the message was completely muddled, because when the president said, I can override the governors, as you pointed out, president cannot override the governors. And then when Kayleigh McEnany was asked about it, she didn't really answer the question. She says she wants the governors, in accordance with the guidelines, to open up the churches. And she said, it's safe to open your churches if you follow the guidelines. So what does that mean if a governor believes that because of asymptomatic spread or because perhaps churches are too small and can't have the distancing or perhaps don't have the opportunity to do services outside, that this could be an issue? And lots of governors are opening up churches. There are some governors with, you know, high amounts of COVID left who are more skeptical about it. So this isn't about faith. It isn't about the First Amendment. It is about public health, and it is about trying to keep people safe. And, you know, the issues are clear, and I just think you can't confuse them.
Yeah, this is about politics. This is not about public health, to be clear.